Surgeries require many experts to be present and some in and out to access medical supplies, to consult, and to relieve staff. But increasingly, due to advances in surgical techniques and safety, there can sometimes be too much traffic in operating rooms across the country, says Dr. Avery Nathans.
Every time the door opens, it takes 20 to 30 seconds to close because they're automatic doors. As a result of that, there's actually a fair bit of exposure of the patient to the hallway and to this disrupted airflow.
Operating rooms are designed to be sterile environments. Air flows from the ceiling downward to keep any bacteria on the floor away from surgical wounds. But every time the door opens, it disrupts this airflow, increasing the risk of infection. Observational studies have also found operating room traffic can be a distraction for surgical staff and suggest using methods like intercoms and signs to reduce the movement of staff, medical students, and observers. Dr. Nathan says it's an issue many hospitals need to address.
So there are several initiatives underway to try to reduce the amount of traffic in the operating room.
At Sunnybrook, special locks have been installed to keep the doors of some operating rooms closed at crucial points during surgery. Posters remind staff of the issue, and there is a push to change the culture around this issue by having staff like Cheryl Milne on hand, encouraging unnecessary people to leave.
It's very proactive, is what it is. And we're always trying to strive for the next best thing.
Dr. Nathan says it's important to start the conversation, shift expectations, and model ideal practices.
No one wants to tell other people to leave the room. Mm-hmm. We want to make that an expectation.
Making everyone mindful that even the simplest things can make a big difference. With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.